In the Eastern York community, we're lucky to have a place where you can buy fresh produce and other locally sourced products. And what's more, at Flinch Ball's Orchard and Farm Market, it's a hub for family-friendly activities throughout the year. There are pick-your-own opportunities and festivals, and there's also a pavilion where you can enjoy a kid's birthday party like we did. We got to pick our own pumpkins and paint them, and we had a great time. Now let's go meet Julie and check out the facilities.
Our story dates back to here on this property, 1951, when my great-grandparents Jacob and Minnie Flinchball purchased this farm here in York County. In Helen Township, beautiful. My grandparents had previously farmed in Lancaster County. My great-grandparents said, no, too many people, boo. They moved back to York. Prior to that, they were in Loganville. So they moved around a little bit until they finally found their home here in Helen Township. I'm glad they stayed here personally because I think it's pretty wonderful. My grandparents actually were the first ones to live on the farm. My great-grandparents purchased it, but my grandparents are the ones that live here. My dad was born and raised here. He passed a legacy of love onto my two older brothers and myself. So the five of us, my parents, Richie and Sonia, Michael and Andrew, and myself, make up the business as far as ownership and operation of it. It takes a lot more than just the five of us to make it happen. We have about 35 to 40 employees, it depends on the season, and we have about 8 full-time employees with that. We cash grain crop, corn, soybeans, wheat, hay. We also have a hog finishing operation where we raise pigs from 50 pounds to 250 pounds to go to market. We have our wholesale fruit, which we're out in the orchard right now. We have an apple processing for dried and fresh apples. And then we have the farm market and agritainment business that you are kind of visiting today, which we're so glad you're here. So the farm market actually is celebrating its 15th anniversary in 2020. What a year to celebrate 15 years. It's a good chance for us to, you know, gear up and try some new things. So the farm market has been here for 15 years and we are so proud to see how it's grown. Our community has helped it grow because without them, we wouldn't really be thriving. The store has grown and a lot of it has grown because people have given suggestions. Anything from, of course, our fresh fruits and vegetables to frozen meats, beef, pork, sausages, to Peridale milks, to cheeses from York Valley and Helham, to cheeses from September Farms in Lancaster, canned goods. Who wants apple butter? One of our best-selling items is our peach and apple salsas. You cannot top them. Like, if you tell me you don't like salsa, you'll try this and be like, oh, maybe I do like salsa. Peach and apple are the top two. So lots of different items held within the market, and it really just offers people a chance to, what we always like to say, we're a hub for all things local. So if you want to try something from Epic Pickles or from Brother Floyd Pickles, we have them here because we want to source items from other businesses like ours and offer it to the community. One thing that's really important to my family, and it's something that my dad has always had a passion for and he instilled that into us, is that this soil, this land is ours for now. And it's our opportunity to grow for now, but someone needs to carry it on in the future. It needs to be in the same condition that we have it now for the next generation. Whether it's my sons or my nieces and nephews, whoever is farming it, they need to have the same opportunity, the same quality of soil and just and nutrients and everything. One of the main things is no-till farming. So all of our corn, soybeans, down to our sunflowers and pumpkin patches are planted no-till. Meaning we don't till the soil ahead of time. We plant a cover crop after harvest in the fall. It grows all winter long. That helps to hold the nutrients and the in place. So when we have heavy rains on that soil, it is not gonna wash away. We wanna keep that soil and the nutrients right where it is. We plant in the spring, the nutrients hold tight there, just grows through season. So we're practicing no-till farming. In the orchard, and you can maybe kind of see, we have irrigation lines out through the orchard, okay? The irrigation lines is drip. We don't turn that on until we have a drought or we have problems, okay? We're emitting water right at the roots of the trees, so we're utilizing technologies in that way to really make sure we're saving as much as we can, those things that we have, precious water and soil. Our events have ebbed and flowed. I remember our very first one was it was an open house. We did it the second summer we were open, just as a thank you to the community for growing with us. Some of my favorite is the first one in the spring, which is our Easter apple hunt, because everyone hunts eggs, but let's hunt apples. We're an orchard. So we hide apples. That's one of my favorite. The Tetra Tractor Day, which is typically held in June, but it's gonna be held in August this year due to the whole climate going on. That's a super fun one too, because We have little tractors, we have big tractors, we have small implements, we have big implements. And not everyone knows what they are. And it's for kids, it's for adults. And so it really just brings everyone together to say, hey, what is Flinch Falls, or what is our local farmer doing? What are they using? And what's that thing that I see in the field? Oh, look, I can come see it and learn about it myself.